Welcome to the ELTP Minus Playoff Final.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the main event. Let's get ready to rumble!
Yes, welcome to the ELTP Minus Playoff Final. It's going to be a great game between Fred Ball Salzburg and Ballis Saint Germain. I am joined, of course, in the commentary box by our captain's commissioner, Mike C, and one of the Ballis majors players, Sheldon. Good evening, chaps. How are you doing?
Good evening, Doctor. Doing good, thanks. How about you?
Not bad, thanks. The voice has recovered from yesterday. Sheldon, how are you doing, mate?
He did say BRB.
Oh, well, that's awkward. So, Mike, how are you looking forward to this game? What's going to happen?
Should be a cracking game. I mean, the two excellent teams. Both have been really active throughout the season, which is great to see for Miners League. And they're two top teams. Looking at the table throughout the season, Ballis Saint Germain came second overall. Fred Ball came fifth overall.
And we've got a look at... Oh, go on, sorry, Mike.
No, go ahead.
No. After you, sir.
It should be a great game between two top teams, I think. Looking at the team lineups, I think you were going to go to.
Yeah, so we've got DZ, Sunner, Green and Pookie. Pookie obviously playing two finals in a row after playing the... He played the Majors final yesterday, that's right, isn't it?
Yeah, he did.
And we've got Carbon, JJ Paul, Smack and 11 for the Fred Ball Salzburg team. There's a few difficult... I don't like commentating the name 11. I don't know, it's a strange name to say in commentary. Not
already showing favouritism. It's controversial.
I might just call him Double One, do you know? Just to like mix it up a little bit.
I like it.
So, Mike, who are the standout players for tonight? Who do you think is going to really help their team to victory? Who's going to, you know, make the fattening part two?
Pookie had a fantastic season on Miners. He's shown he's jumped up to Majors. But in Miners, 40 caps in 250 minutes, which is sensational. And defence, Green and DZ are lockdown defence. They are fantastic throughout the season. In terms of Fred Ball Salzburg, you know, they've got a lot of experienced players. Carbon and Wowsatch Pro, a great offensive pair. 11 and Nihlis has done well, but I think is it JJ Paul playing tonight? It is. Those two also done well on defence. New Comp doesn't like the name Final for this, so this will be the last match of the season rather than the final.
Right, it's probably because New Comp's teams that win finals,
as we
saw yesterday. It's a fact. New Comp's teams don't win finals. Are the Miners team for Ballis Saint Germain about to prove that wrong? I mean, they've got a strong team, some very experienced players that have played at Majors level, some of them. So, you know, let's hope they can bring some sort of glory to New Comp's. But
I am going to back BSG this game. From what I've heard, Pookie, obviously we know, is fantastic. Sunner, I've heard, has really been stepping up recently. I've heard she's been doing some amazing jukes. She jukes me in a pub, didn't let me live it down. And so I might going to give the edge to BSG based on that.
We should be getting underway any second soon. I think that the team's close to being ready. So JJ Paul, where's he based? He's not based locally, is he?
I believe he's American. If he's Canadian, I apologise.
North American. And everyone else, I think, based in Europe, is that right?
I don't know about Wowsatch Pro, actually. He actually said in group East Coast all day. So...
Although he isn't starting today.
Could be why. Maybe he's going to wait till Orbit.
DZ, one of our rare Scottish players, of course. And
DZ. Sorry?
BSG are ready. Fred Ball Salzburg already, so we should be ready to go. We're joined by Sheldon. Sheldon, looking forward to this final?
I am looking forward to it, yep. Hopefully get one BSG team to win.
Just saw you in the team channel giving a last minute team talk.
Just giving prepping them, you know, for the big game ahead here. Just to treat it like a normal game, any game they play, so they don't get nervous.
Good stuff. Who are you backing to make an impact in this game? Either team.
Pookie's obviously the favourite offender for BSG, but I feel Sunny holds pretty well, so I think she's going to make a big impact. For Fred Ball, they've got JJ. He's pretty solid coming from America, and again, Carbon, pretty solid on him.
Well, off we go. In the ELTB minus final, Smack gets a rolling bomb from the middle, not diffused, and 11 with a tag pro, so a strong start for them. Smack still got that rolling bomb. It's diffused, though. DZ and Green managing to diffuse it, but Smack does get the grab.
He's got
a break has been called already, so Carbon lagged, I think, and I think we're going to go back to group very soon. Carbon did lag, but now he's actually grabbed. And the break called by, is that Fred Ball Salzburg that have called the break? So they
I think it's BSG.
Is it?
It's BSG.
I'm colourblind. I'm not very good with the colours, believe it or not, in the text. It's not
and that was it.
No, I'm going to go check what happened. There we go.
Full start to this final.
Sheldon, being a great commentator, disappearing basically all the time. You couldn't have found one person that maybe wasn't actually his team, you know, playing.
We want to be nice and biased. It's just a good way to go.
It's just because when he's not here, I've got to really, force the conversation.
I'm forcing it when naturally speaking.
It was yesterday, you and Chris just rabbited on whilst I had a little bit of a break.
Yeah, I'm happy to talk.
Go on then.
Oh, there is some controversy in the group. DZ claiming they won because of the Kep flag. I mean, Kep flags. Oh, I've got some exclusive news from Sunna. Pookie's lagging on Cord and she's lagging on Orbit.
Ooh, who else have they got, Mike?
Oh, in terms of BSG, they've got some great players. Let me just look at their mumble channel.
Let me just look at their roster.
Camford did well throughout the season. 188 minutes on Miners. He got a solid 14 cap. Camford the Panther could step in. We saw a Fly make a great YouTube video. Another American there. Don't know how they're doing, Cord. Looks like there might be. Are they going to change it up?
I mean, forget the fattening. I mean, this playoff season, both majors and minors, has been the lagging. I mean, it's just lag on both servers for different players from different places. It's been a bit of a strange one.
Cord has had a lot of issues lately, especially for UK players. Which hasn't been great, as we saw in the final yesterday. Orb clearly favouring Cord, as he did in the semi-final. But mind me, I think they did a lot better on Orbit as it is, so. And just trying to work out what's happening. Wowslash Pro saying, put me in, coach. And looks like Sheldon's making an Orbit group. We have got an Orbit group. Posted in the group chat.
We're going to Orbit already?
They are playing on Orbit.
Dramatic scenes here, ladies and gentlemen. Quick, mate, get a spec spot. Get a spec spot.
I've got a spec spot already. I'm first in there. Carbon clarifying the rules. I'm just going to check that myself. There is, of course, controversy about which team gets to pick which half. BSG, as the higher ranked team, get the first choice, and BSG are choosing Orbit for their half. That is confirmed. I do have the rules open in another tab just in case, but hopefully there will be no issues. If you're on the stream, the chat, make sure you give us your predictions in chat. Let us know who you think's going to win, what's going to happen in this game. Sheratano is group leader. So I cannot start this, not a fan of this.
Surely he needs to make you group leader.
Apparently I've got practice of some sort. Oh, core contenders. That's not you flick down, that's fine.
Yeah, I actually supposed to be practicing.
Core contenders is a serious thing. Make sure you check out r/core contenders if you are interested. Done by Kyrie Irvin. It's a great way to friends team up and play some tag pro out of the regular season. And as another reminder, Region Wars is very soon. I believe Sam and Carbon are helping organise that. Or are organising it. Make sure you sign up, put your region in, and put yourself down as Team Essex. We've got a great team.
Team Essex, oh god. I've actually unsuppressed Heisenberg and LP in the hope that one of them will speak. I'm not sure if it's going to happen. Hi, guys!
Hey, what's up?
Oh, they were just waiting for their moment, weren't they?
I am going to be awkward now and jump out.
But I might... Oh, fucking hell. This is absolute shambles. Bye, Mike. He's gone. He's left us. Sheldon's back. Sheldon, what's going on?
He started the game with 400 ping, so... And he didn't seem to be getting better on the cord, so we switched to Orbit.
Fair enough. Heisenberg's joined us. Heisenberg, how do you see this game going?
I reckon it'll be quite close. I can see it going narrowly either way.
Narrowly either way. That's a bold, bold prediction there.
I'd probably say Fred Ball.
LP, would you agree with that?
Yeah, it's going to be a tight one. I would, however, give it to BSG, despite Newcomb's jinxing it.
Yeah, well, Newcomb's on the bench. I doubt he'll jinx it too much. It is going to be a tight game. Sheldon, how much belief do you have in your team, really? They probably won't watch this part. They'll skip straight to the games. If you want to say the shit, you can say it now.
I have a lot of faith in them. They've played very well up till this point. I don't see why I can't do it again. I haven't watched any of Fred Ball's games, but they've clearly done well to get here. And they beat Tech Pro Rangers last round, so...
I thought you were about to say you haven't watched any of your team's games.
No.
What is the hold up now? All this bullshit talking. There's nothing to talk about. I want to play the game. Well, not play. Watch. I feel like I should just put some like funny vines on or something.
he's the break.
Yeah. We're going to cut to some funny vines until it all starts.
Clear! Hey, what you looking for?
Looking for pussy, nigga.
All across the world, still hitting them counters in them lolos, girl. Still taking my time to.
Chris, why does it smell illegal in here?
I don't know.
Selfie!
Ah, you ruined my selfie! You stupid!
Means they won't have another break this half.
They were pretty terrible vines. I'm really sorry to everyone watching. I mean, I typed funny vines into YouTube and that compilation came up, but it was strange.
If BSG have lag issues, they will need to sub someone out and get someone in. They can't have five people, no more breaks.
But it's nice to know we've got a sportsman-like team here in Fred Salzburg.
It was controversial down there. All of them agreed they wanted the quarters of break to get as much advantage as they can. The award voting is over, so they saw no need in being fair play.
Athletic Cap already wrapped that one up.
Yet again, fair play award.
I did try to lose it for us in the semis, but...
It was a good effort.
There's a tag pro mid and the rolling bomb either side, so they're going to fight for that tag pro.
Looks like Sunny might have the best spawn for it.
3, 2.
Yeah, Sunny should get that. Almost certainly. Smack's probably going to get sacrificed in the process. Sunny does get it. Avoids killing Smack, but takes out JJ, Paul, Carbon, and DZ with a rolling bomb apiece. Carbon's is neutralized. Sunny grabs with that tag pro. She's going to get returned. No, she doesn't. The bombs miraculously keep her alive, but she gets spiked for the second time. And Smack is coming in here, actually. Smack has got a good chance to cap, but Green with a bit of a hit and hope boost. Last ditch attempt. Manages to get the return. He's got the grab at the other end. The JJ pool gets a double return there. Carbon with a grab at the other end. He gets returned, and some early flaccid grabs from both teams. Power-ups not giving us too much. Pookie and Sunner going in on the offense. And Sheldon, how is Pookie going to do playing, you know, with Sunner without you to carry him?
It's very fair to say, but he doesn't have to play fat anymore, so, you know, might ease it a bit.
Carbon's looking to come in here, but there's four people in his way, so he'll do well. Three of them now, one of them spiked. DZ comes up to meet him. Carbon waits for him. He comes down, but he decides to run the map a bit. Power-ups are spawning. JJ Paul, if he gets something interesting from the middle, he doesn't, though. But Carbon's got a rolling bomb, but DZ's got a tag pro. Can Carbon get there before DZ puts that tag pro to use? He uses it. He bombs Pookie out of the way, but he gets returned. Pookie grabs, though, and there's a tag pro spawning, but Carbon manages to get the return. Smack, DZ over-committing there. Smack lures him into the bottom bit of wall there. And BSG have been quite flaccid, but they finally managed to get out of base properly. Pookie grabbing, bringing it up to the top left, whereas Salzburg carrying probably a lot better so far of the two teams. And 11 gets a nice snipe on Pookie there, boosting backwards, but risky, break. But good smart tactic. And
that was at 20.
Break call at 20. So on the minute, we'll be going back to group yet again. Both teams having lag issues here. Can anyone force it with the 8 seconds we've got left? They're going to try and get this return on Sunner, and Fred Ball is being aggressive here, but it's not going to happen, and we are going back to group again.
That does mean both teams have used up their break, so if there are lag issues, they'll need to do a substitute instead.
LP,
a bit of a slow start to this game.
What's going on?
It seems like the lag issues are killing both teams, just like we saw last night.
Well, last night they all played on like champions, and although it didn't work for Ballis, you know, we got an exciting game. The lag made it hectic.
That's true.
Come on, guys, don't make me put the vines back on. They really
we do
work.
Not need more vines.
They really work good. I don't know if anyone... There was one of someone looking down a microscope. And he just went, what are you looking for? He went, looking for pussy. And I was just like, I have no idea what that is, but that made me chuckle, actually.
This has been end-to-end stuff, literally.
We've been, like, the stream's been going for half an hour and we've had 3 minutes of play. No, 2 minutes of play.
We did get Mrs. Sims, Sam's mum, involved in the decision-making earlier. We'll see if she makes another appearance.
Sorry, you got Sam's mum involved?
Yeah, Sam asked his mum whether she should go break or back to group. Am I priority speaker? No, I'm not. I might just be loud.
Well, what are they saying? That I'm not loud?
Lojo thinks that I'm loud. The game sound... There's complaints about the noise levels. Is that better, Lojo?
Let me lower the game sounds a bit. Probably too quiet now. And I think you'll have been turned down as well, Mike. See, this is what happens when you get amateurs to stream it, because Carbon's playing.
Well, it's why we lost the semi-final, just to make sure that yourself could commentate the main final. Be thinking of the community.
That is a sacrifice that me, Mike, Kutra, Strat, the rest of the Athletic App team made. And, you know...
And that's why we won Fair Play, Best Coach, Best Teammate.
Best commentator.
All best very commentator. Sketchily.
All very sketchily. please.
To be fair, BSG did come second in a lot of awards, which is, you know...
and in the final.
I'm just saying, we reach finals and we didn't get best coach award. I don't know what's happened there. Mike, any input? How did your miners do?
Oh, apparently, a solid 12th in the season.
Both teams are ready, Mike.
Okay, if I've just dragged you in, please don't speak, just listen. Both teams are ready, going to launch again.
Whey!
It was in the listen room, there is issues that hopefully everyone can hear us loud and clear.
It's just
so 8 minutes left this game. There should be no more breaks.
Well, there can't be any more breaks. They have to subs, don't they?
There will have to be rolling subs.
And we can finally get the Miners final up and going properly.
And we are playing Rush Goalie.
What?
Rolling subs, Rush Goalie, bit of five-a-side rules.
Excellent.
Well, such pro, looking for the bomb, it's always risky to go for mid. But someone's got the better spawn if it pays off though.
3, 2, 1.
Let's see, can Wow Such Pro get that tag pro from mid? Karma's gonna bomb him. No, he doesn't. He just bombs himself backwards towards the flag. It didn't really work out very well. As Sunny's got a tag pro, and so has Green. So double tag pro for BSG. Are they gonna put that to good use? Let's see. Pookie yet to get a grab. They're defending well, Carbon 11 against that tag pro. Very well played. I mean, but Pookie manages to get the grab, but 11 gets the return, and they've neutralised that double tag pro, and BSG will be disappointed that they've not put it to good use. A scrappy start from both teams. It is a scrappy map until the flag gets out of base. Neither team managing to get the flag out of base and keep it out successfully for very long, as Carbon has got the re-grab. But Sunny gets returned by JJ Paul. Pookie with the re-grab should be spurred on by his Miners performance yesterday, but he isn't, and 11 gets the return. We've got power-ups coming in 10 seconds. And Mike, it is a very nervy start from both teams.
Yeah, I mean, the two breaks aren't going to help either team. Bit a few nervous grabs, you know, a lot of flatted so far. No one's got over 10 seconds hold. A couple on chance get out, it's just not happening.
Let's
see. The pups will be important.
Pookie is going to look like they're going to get mid-nailed down. They've got a tag pro, so that could be vital for them. JJ Paul, in the meantime, just gets a rolling bomb, which gets diffused. And Sunny takes out one of them with that tag pro, and I don't know if she's going to grab. No, she's not going to grab. She's shown discipline. She's probably screaming for Pookie to come and grab the flag. She takes one of that. Pookie gets a grab, and now he's got a lead, and that's good play by Sunny and Pookie. And they're coming in. Only Carbon ahead. Carbon's been taken out, but Wild Such Pro comes across, but surely a cap for BSG, and it is 1-0 to them. A nice cap there, Sheldon.
Yeah, Sunny made up for a mistake with her first tag pro, and she definitely used that one a lot better.
Wild Such Pro looking to hit back, though, for Fred Ball Salzburg, but he's being caught over the right-hand side. But he's coming in. There's four coming into base. He's got to rush it here. He does, but Green manages to get the return. DZ has got the grab. Acaba with the re-grab as well. DZ gets returned by 11. Pookie grabs and just gets away from JJ Paul. Thanks to a good block by Sunny. Acaba goes over the flag spot, but to no avail. And now Pookie's ahead of three. And Wild Such Pro, he grabs. It's a risky grab, but he's managed to get out. And that's bold play by Wild Such Pro as he boosts along the bottom. Power-ups are spawning. There's a rolling bomb mid. JJ Paul gets it. It's diffused. He leaves a rolling bomb for his teammate. Carry the flag. And Wild Such Pro, he missed it. Surely that's laggy. Missed that rolling bomb and spiked. But Carbon is coming in. Only one ahead. Surely they can get the blocks of DZ. They do. It's going to be an equalising cap. And that's 1-1. And this game has livened up all of a sudden, Mike.
Yeah, weird play at the top. Missed the rolling bomb and spiked himself. But suddenly Fred Ball Salzburg back in it with an equalising cap.
And we've got 5 minutes 30 left in this half. Now the teams are settled and we can see some proper tag pro being played. Wild Such Pro did miss that rolling bomb at the top and spiked himself, but it all worked out. They had Pookie's on the flag spot. No, he's not. He was on the flag spot nearly. We're too quiet, bloody hell. People can't make up their mind. Take over, Mike.
And obviously, Green and Carbon both carrying the flag. Carbon needs to stay alive. He's got teammates ahead. Perhaps should be spawned in about 15 seconds. And see both players. Oh, good return by Pookie.
And JJ Paul.
No much chasing going on.
There's not. Green is allowed to walk into base basically unchallenged, but Wild Such Pro 11 and Carbon awkward across. BSG got the better of the power up so far. JJ Paul sacrificed himself but manages to get a tag pro. DZ's got a tag pro as well. I didn't see the top power up, but I think we can safely assume that one may have disappeared already. Sunny's coming in, but JJ Paul's ahead with. Oh, it's now. Yes, it's delayed. Top is delayed. DZ tries to lead Sunny through by kissing with a tag pro, but Carbon's there to grab and get out.
No one's grabbed it yet.
No one has grabbed it. JJ Paul's remembered. He's going to restocked up his tag pro. So that one's severely delayed, and I wonder if that's going to have a big impact on the game. Pookie coming in. 11 has to live here, but he goes for the kiss. No, he doesn't. Green gets the snipe on him. And JJ Paul could be in trouble here. Green gets the return. Wild Such Pro gets bombed into the... Oh, Wild Such Pro got bombed into the flag. I don't think he was going to go for it. And actually, it was one of the BSG players maybe that bombed him in. I'm not sure. But Pookie carrying down the bomb. It's a very tight, tense game. Neither team able to get reset too well. Wild Such Pro's boosted into a spike. He seems to be a bit spike hungry today. But as Pookie heads up into base, Carbon down in that bottom left, he gets... pincered and gets returned, and pops are spawning. Green takes a tag pro from mid, and BSG getting a lot of tag pros but not able to turn those tag pros into a lead so far. Top is not for another 15 seconds, but Green's waiting for it, and he might waste his entire tag pro waiting for top to spawn.
10 seconds.
And Wild Such Pro boosts along the bottom as Pookie nearly gets returned by JJ Paul. And Green must know that it's still not gone. He's going to get it now. He gets the juke juice and nearly gets a snipe on Wild Such Pro. Mike, tight game so far.
Yeah, it's been very tight. I think both teams still a bit nervous. Hopefully going to the game a bit more. Chance here, maybe. Pookie's coming in.
Pookie's coming in. He's only got good one kill to beat. Green's got a tag pro... Juju, sorry. Surely he can get the block. Oh, and the bomb works out. Not sure if it's intended, though. If it was just a little bit lucky, but it's worked out for BSG. And WildSearch Pro has rage quit because of that cap. Don't know if that's a lag issue or a rage quit, but they really need a fourth ball on the tiles to Fred Ball Salzburg. He has rejoined as WildSearch Pro, but it could be too late as Sunny comes in. Sunny comes in from the back. She nearly cuts. 11 gets a grab and Carbon gets a return. Pookie taking them out with that tag pro. He's going to go get a Superman. And BSG, Sheldon, definitely better on the power up so far.
Yeah, it seems like they've really dominated them. Saw JJ waiting on bottom pop after it had gone. So maybe a bit of miscommunication for Fred Ball at the moment.
JJ does seem to be the only person I've seen really going for the power ups. For Fred Ball, but like you say, it's a team effort. We do need more players to do it. But it's 2-1 at the minute to Ballis Saint Germain. Looking for to take this miners title. We'll quick look at the stats there. Pookie with 2 minutes hold so far. Definitely leading the hold. WildSearch Pro of a minute and a half. But Pookie's been carrying well. 2 minutes hold, two caps. But Pookie's away here looking for his third cap. Carbon's grabbed and Carbon has to live and they end up kissing. And we've got 2 minutes left. More power-up spawning in the middle and down at the bottom. JJ Paul again fighting for mid, but he's fighting for mid against two once again. And once again, they lose out on a tag pro. And Fred Ball Salzburg really need to get on top of these power-ups a little bit more. 11's coming in, but Sunny's going to help Pookie out with ease after taking out the Fred Ball Salzburg defense with that tag pro. Sunny spikes herself as Carver gets a snipe. And actually, they could bring it in here. Fred Ball going to bring it in. It's a tight gap and it works out. It's a great block. Great play there by Fred Ball Salzburg. Despite Sunny having that tag pro. And Tarbin's leading through. They could hit back immediately. And they have. And out of nowhere, they turned it around. One tag pro. A great bit of skill. And suddenly, Fred Ball Salzburg have got two caps. And are leading this final 3-2. Mike, great little bit of play there.
Yeah, great bomb usage by both teams. First for Green. I just want to highlight Green's defensive work for BSG second. He killed one with a bomb, cleared the bomb out for the cap as well. And then a nice bomb and tag for a lead and suddenly two caps and it swung the other way.
And we always talk about just the small, little, tiny errors that often don't matter that could cost a team a game. I mean, Sunny spiked herself and kind of ended up behind by accident. And two caps gone straight like that. I mean, it's crazy the things that can happen.
It's such a small map, small margins make a huge difference.
And then WildSearch Pro's picked up another tag pro to lead JJ Paul through. He's got full
tag. Not a great lead.
No, the lead. Where's the lead? The lead's not happening. JJ Paul gets killed and he'll be frustrated with WildSearch Pro. I mean, Heisenberg, if you're still with us, they should have probably got another cap there or at least brought it into base.
I think that was more JJ Paul's fault for not following WildSearch Pro better.
That's a good point, but Carbon, with 13 seconds left, could get something going here. No, he can't. But Sunny nearly gets out. But this half looks like it's going to finish with Fred Ball Salzburg in the lead. 3-2. Quick look at the stats before they pop up on your screen. We've got Pookie with the two caps, 11 with one. Carbon and JJ Paul with a cap apiece. But 31 returns for BSG there compared to the 17. It was a tight half. Fred Ball Salzburg with that quick double, Mike. It's left them with the advantage.
Yeah, I'd say BSG were generally on top. I mean, Green and Dribbly Zedra had a great defensive performance. I think Green performed really well, especially. But two quick caps, said Sunny made a mistake, and a tag pro lead. And Fred Ball Salzburg narrowly on top. And looks like Sheldon has gone down to speak to his team, try to motivate him a bit. Let him know what went wrong.
LP, Heisey, you guys, what do you think? What do BSG need to do to avoid losing in the final again?
Ooh, it's a big order for them right now, it seems. It definitely seems like they need to pull together and communicate better.
I mean, they had the power-up times down. They just didn't always utilize them.
They didn't really utilize them.
And are we staying in orbit? Are we switching, Mike? What's happening in terms of servers?
I was wondering about that.
I think we are staying.
Sam is spamming the chat. That is his first warning. So if you're on stream, let us know who you think's going to win this half. It looks like we are staying in orbit. We've got 50 viewers this final.
How are we doing volume-wise? Apparently I fucked it all up.
There's been no complaints lately.
There were some harsh ones that before.
Yep, such as now Mike is too quiet.
Sort it out.
Mike, you sounded better before. Okay, have I swapped teams? I think so. Are we going to see any subs, do you think?
I have no opinion. I'm just a play-by-play commentator.
Pad
down there, Heisey, jump in here, boys.
What? Ooh, I mean, it requires some deep background knowledge to know about the subs.
It doesn't look like they're making any changes. How long can Pookie play for, though?
Yeah,
that's a good question.
Has this not been considered?
As LP is the Miners Commissioner, I will let LP answer that question.
Well, I'll need to look at his stats for last night before I come up.
Welcome back, Dr. McDonald.
Hey, leave, mate. I didn't leave. I was like a ninja.
Apparently, game sounds are too loud relative to mumble. The in-game sounds.
Oh, God. Right, let me turn Chrome down. Oh, God.
You can see all the effort we are going through to make sure the stream is...
What? Who let Carbon play? Bloody hell. I used to be able to stream, but then, like, it was like, good. You know, like, but not many people streamed. And now, like, Carbon screams. Everyone wants, like, such high-quality stuff. They should just be happy that the map's in the middle of the map. And I used to carry my mouse cursor around the thing, so they should just be happy that the mouse cursor's not, like... I definitely streamed one game where people were, like, you know, mouse cursor for MVB.
I think I remember that.
Right, I've turned Chrome down, so it should be quieter, the game sounds. Probably won't be able to hear them now, but it's fine.
The game sounds aren't too important, it's mainly your magical voice people want to hear.
Yeah, like me and volume is a problem.
So, Dr. Tess, how you feel? You won Best Commentator 4th season in a row.
Well, genuinely very, very, very humbled. It's nice to actually... I consider it quite a privilege to be able to commentate kind of like the finals and stuff like that, because it is really exciting games, and I don't take it for granted that I do try and work hard to make sure that the commentary is of a good standard. And yeah, just keep working to improve it, and hopefully, you know, keep eLTP known for its commentary and exciting moments better than MLTP.
Good stuff.
Did you hear that when you moved to the other room?
No, still can't hear you. Hopefully Carbon's trying to sort it.
Yeah, no, I mean, so what is it? People can't hear me, they'll listen to the live stream room.
Yeah.
That's really strange because, I mean, I commentate in here normally and people can hear me.
There we go. Temporary solution. Teams are ready. We are launching for the second half.
Sheldon, how are your boys going to get back in it?
Keep up the power-up control. They seem to let it slip at the end of that, at the tail end of that game. I thought they made some silly mistakes with some of their caps. So I said just in base, just positioning is quite key when those bombs are around, so they've got to be careful of that.
And looks like two Duke Juices and a rolling bomb.
Keep talking, Mike. I'll be second.
Okay.
What's the score for the first half?
3-2 to Fred Ball Salzburg. And that's a good bomb. DZ gets the Duke Juice mid. That's good play from BSG to get the pop. Sunner spikes herself. Never mind. And the top one's defused fairly quickly. And not a lot happening in Duke Juice in each defense. Don't really see Sunner's away. Never mind.
That was a nice grab.
Nice grab.
Shame she couldn't get away.
If you've got a Duke Juice lurking, it's always risky to grab, especially on this smaller map. So is it both teams with flaccid grabs? Well, such might get up. Nope, straight into DZ and Green. And Shelly, I've been impressed by Green so far. What do you think about him?
Yeah, he's a good player. He's just come from pubs this season. He's proved that he's a very good player. Can be risky at times, but you know, risky pays off.
Risky can pay off quite a lot. The Carbon and Wellsarch Pro trying to get some grabs. Carbon, some nice jukes there.
He does kind of get out of base. No, DZ gets the return. And power ups are spawning again as we're down the first minute. Wellsarch Pro might get a grab off though. And sometimes that can lead to advantages when people. But he ends up eating Spike again. He has definitely been a bit good accident prone so far. But it was a good grab by Sunner. Sunner is lucky to come in. Oh, she gets past 11 at high speed. But JJ Paul gets a return. Nothing exciting from the pups. I think maybe they were all rolling bombs.
Yeah, they were.
So nothing exciting. Pookie's bringing it in.
27 chance.
Great. Pookie's boosted directly at flag, but it's difficult when there's four people in your way. All you've got to do is spread yourselves out in a reasonable fashion, and you'll get the returns.
Flaccid.
Two flaccid. Sunny's got to force it here. She does. She goes against the steps there, but isn't able to capitalise and cap. Remember, a little faux pas there. Ballis Saint Germain, down by one, but Pookie's bringing it in here to equalise, and he does just a grab a flaccid at the wrong time for Fred Ball Salzburg, and they've thrown their one cap lead away, and this game's tied up at 3-3 as power ups are spawning. Sunner's got a good position on mid, but she gets bombed out of it, and she's lost out. Wellsarch Pro's got it. What can he do there to get Fred Ball Salzburg the cap back? Pookie's got a rolling bomb from the top. Carbon gets a rolling bomb, I think, from the bottom, which is diffused. As Sunny gets the grab, but Wellsarch Pro has got that tag pro. So really would be difficult for Ballis Saint Germain to come in here. But they are coming in. Nevertheless, Sunny is coming in on the left-hand side, but she gets returned. Wellsarch Pro gets a grab just as his tag pro runs out. Pookie's got a rolling bomb yet to be defused. 11 gets a defuse just as we say that. 7 minutes 30 left on the clock as Pookie heads to the top. Wellsarch Pro to the bottom, but Green gets the return. Carbon with a re-grab. He's pinned on this right side of the map by Green, but it gets past him with ease. DZ lining up a snipe, takes out the boost, and Carbon under pressure there from the bomb got a face full of Spike. JJ Paul and Sunny kissing. Wellsarch Pro grabbing, going up the right hand side. And Mike, a tied game. Are we going to see a really close finish just like we did in the Majors final?
I reckon we'll do, yeah. Wormy always brings tight games. It's a great map for the final. For that last cap, 11 seemed to really fuck it up. I mean, don't know how it mistakes, but he had lined up on a boost. He went completely the wrong way to the top corner. He could have stayed ahead, went to the top corner, and suddenly it was a nice easy cap.
And Wellsarch Pro is been running around.
Fuck it.
Wellsarch Pro has been running around in base for a little while, but he's going to get returned now as Green comes in with just one ahead, and somehow they're nearly going to cap. Carbon gets bombed into it, or bombs himself into it, and manages to save Fred Ball Salzburg from being one cap down there. But somehow, after trying to force it for the cap, Fred Ball nearly ended up conceding the cap actually. And no one's on re for Fred Ball right now. They've got no re-grab, which is a dangerous tactic on this map, but Carbon manages to get there. Green is almost trying to neutralise that re-grab, but in the effort to do that, Wellsarch Pro has got out, and they could force it here. They force it on Sunner. They could get the reset, but no one covers the outside. Sunner is pinned there. They could try and get a reset, but Sunner, good use of the bomb. Very smart, experienced play from Sunner there, and she manages to escape base. Sunner comes into base now. She's sat on the flag square. Carbon needs to live. JJ Poole manages to get ahead to get the re-grab. And Sheldon, are you tense right now? Sheldon?
Can't pardon?
Are you tense? Are you tense?
A little bit, as the moment of silence there, but yeah, they're looking a lot better, I feel, than the last game. They're covering
Dominated
each other's
pop control.
Re-grabs quite well.
BSG got all three pops there. Fred Ball didn't even go for any of them.
And Fred Ball are suffering with the power-up control so far, but it's not suffering in the scoreline so far. Pookie's called another break. There's a break call, but there's 20 seconds. It was called, 21. And Wellsarch Pro is going to try and force it here. He's got a few seconds. He's got four ahead of him. I'm not sure what he's waiting for. No one's
bombs.
Coming down for
he's
him. He's waiting for the bombs. He is. Yeah, I wish I knew things about Tag Pro. And they take one. Sunny, that forces Sunny into a grab. They're
going
to get the return. He has to force it now. There's not much time left. And the call stops just as Green gets the return. And we are going back to group.
Didn't seem a bit wasteful there. Well, such bro.
Could have rushed it a bit more.
You know, he's got 20 seconds. He might as well try and make a play.
So another BSG break.
Shelly, have a
Which
word.
Which I'll go.
Have
I'm going
word.
To investigate.
Have a word. Sheldon, our roving reporter, Mr. Investigation, is going to find out the gossip.
Yeah, for BSG's cap, it seems 11 was lined up nicely on the boost, and he just went to the top right corner. It was strange to watch.
I didn't catch that. I don't know. I was watching it somewhere. But talk us through what happened, Mike, for the people.
I'm going to watch it back on the stream. This is our instant replay system.
I'm sure there's a way I could probably do that. I don't know how to do it.
You probably could. We're lined up, so...
What time was it on the clock?
I'm just trying to find out. Just trying to find the right passage of play here. Yeah, it's about 46:15 on the stream. 11 seems to be waiting for mid-pop or something. Yeah, 11 was fighting Sana for the mid-pop, and Pookie came in. 11 just went top right. Sana might have pushed him, to be fair. I think it was good work by Sana to push 11 away and away from the flag carrier. So maybe not a fuck-up from 11. Good play from Sana.
So it wasn't a fuck-up. You were wrong. You were lying.
It looked like 11 just boosted top right. In fact, a good block by Sana. And I've just accidentally closed the stream.
Good luck. Good one.
Thanks, man. And so 5 minutes left is all tied up in this game. Just hopefully our roving reporter will come back soon to let us know what's happening.
There you go, you can see Pookie coming in here. 11, oh, 11 got boosted out of the way, it wasn't his fault at all. Suddenly the boost spawned, it was quite unlucky for him there.
Yeah, I think Sana pushed him towards that as well. From what I saw, it looked like 11 just boosted away, but nope, good play from Sana.
Mike, why are you such a bully?
I'm not a bully.
Just saying that he's shit and he wasn't.
Look, I've been voted best coach and best teammate and captain's commissioner.
Not by your own team, mate. We know you.
Anyway, that's that Reg's allegation and...
What's happening in the group?
Bad jokes. One from Sam Sims, what's black and white and red all over? A sunburned zebra.
God, should I just put the, I really should just put the, what do you call it?
The vines
back on, yeah.
Yeah, I think it's probably best.
I don't know who's put this, I don't know who YTM, WoodMG is, but they've put on the stream, Sheldon's voice makes me want to carve my eyes out.
It's a fair comment.
Yeah, to be fair, you're right. So what's the score going into the second half, into the last 5 minutes?
It's currently 3-3, all tied up.
It is 3-3, yeah, 3-3.
As a reminder, if this first game is a tie, it will all come down to the second game, just like we saw last night. Apparently Pookie is laggy, so we may see a substitution. Cam for the Panther might sub in. People saying I should not have won any of the awards and agreeing with Flicchioli. Thank you for the support.
Boo. I love how you started like counting them up. 8-1 of the night for Mike C talking about yourself in the third person. Who does that?
Just being mean now.
Right, what's going on in the group, Mike?
No, don't care. Not much is happening at the moment. Pookie's still lagging, apparently.
This is the slowest final of all time.
There have been slower playoff games. Cash Mines back to Season 2 semi-final.
Oh my god, that was like 3 hours, that stream.
That was a very long game. Plenty of breaks, stoppages, arguments from both teams.
That's good. That's going to be in my eLTP archive. One of the episodes will just be just re-uploading that video.
That was a classic game for the ages. Fred Ball Salzburg are ready. Just wait and see what BSG are going to do. New comp should just ban everyone on the other team before the game starts. That is one of new comp's strategies. Rarely used, but often effective.
Bet you wish they did that yesterday. Oh! Sorry, new comp. Sorry. Please don't ban me. If I go offline, you know why. Ooh! I've just found some of the strawberry laces.
Nice.
Oh, excuse me while I eat a strawberry lace. Oh no, shit, I just dropped my beer. It's alright, it's nearly empty.
So just waiting for both teams. Pookie seems to be joining the game just to make sure his lag is okay, I assume.
Pookie's until I finish my strawberry laces.
He's testing his ping.
Before 420 got banned last night, apparently, for 8 hours. Before the final. Is that true?
Apparently. I'm not too sure about that, actually.
Who is this YT1MG?
I'm not sure.
Who are you?
We're just waiting to see if Pookie's going to come back. Heisenberg, how's your season been?
Oh, fine. It's alright.
Great stuff.
I love that. Heisenberg is like, to the point, always. No bullshit.
Could have gone better. Could have gone worse.
And then, Doctor, how'd you say your season went?
I don't know. I'm kind of getting hooked on these strawberry laces right now.
Okay, we're going to have to come back to Dr. McDonald after the strawberry laces. The game has been going for an hour and we have played 15 minutes.
Oh my god. Wildshots Pro posting a new group. If you want to join it, it's tagproorbitkoalabeast.com/groups/ can we fucking start, please?
Go there for all Pookie's our public back. Games. Pookie is back.
Way.
Pookie, sorry for the hold up. We'll let you off, Pookie.
I won't. This is how I'm spending my evening. I got work tomorrow, do you know what I mean?
I got work tomorrow.
Yeah, but you're not a real teacher.
Oh, if the pace continues, I'll start calling the clock on teams. LP, what do you mean I'm not a real teacher? How dare you? Are both teams ready?
If anyone has any amusing YouTube videos that are less than a minute in length that you want to send me the link to, please do. We'll play them next time there's a stoppage.
Okay, BSG are ready. Let's see if Fred Ball are still ready. They are still ready. We are launching.
Hey.
So, 5 minutes left in game one, half two. Apologies for the numerous delays. Sheldon, what's going on?
You can all blame Pookie. He seems to be having some ping issues. He had to reset his router. He seems to be better, but he's not sure. And apart from that, I made my fish fingers.
Solid stuff. What sort of... What sort of fish finger sandwiches, or...?
Yeah. Of course.
Good choice. Any sauce?
They haven't actually been made yet, though.
What are you planning?
Why are you lying?
Three, two,
anyway, three juke juices to start us off. Nothing exciting there.
1 in 27 chance.
I have run out of strawberry laces, and I'm quite upset about that. And also, I have no beer. So, I'm not going to be very excited this half. Yeah, some people playing Tag Pro. Masters Pro, not grabbing. Oh, but Sonny's coming in. Carbon comes aggressive to meet her with his choo-choo. She did have a choo-choo as well, but he got the return. And early inroads there for BSG, looking to take the lead. Remember, it's 3-3 this game. It's tied at right now. Sonny grabs JJ Poole, comes after her. Wildsuch Pro coming from the other side. But Wildsuch Pro bombing his teammate into a spike, allowing Sonny to escape. She's waiting patiently by the boost. Boost along the bottom. Wildsuch Pro goes into a spike. But BSG are managing to keep the flag dizzy and green, holding that flag in base. And they're looking to be aggressive here. Now, will Pookie take it slowly so Sonny can get some pups? There's still two in base. Pookie boosts all the way across the map. Sonny's going to get mid before going on re.
Could have been a cap there. The boost route was open to the flag, but not a great boost.
Sonny gets a rolling bomb, which is a defuser. The rolling bomb top, and Pookie's got a tag pro bottom. So if they can get the return on carbon here, which they do, Maybe they could get some sort of... DZ grabs Pookie with the lead. The lead doesn't really happen, but DZ manages to get out and Pookie takes out 11. JJ Poole has got the re-grab at the other end and he gets returned. It's going to be a certain cap if DZ can bring it in. He's got a clear boot to the flag and that's a nice cap by BSG and they're winning 4-3 with 3 minutes 30 left. And it could be another. Sunna is past 3. She gets bombed nearly into the spike, manages to avoid it, but that allows 11 to get ahead. But Mike, that was a good cap there.
Yeah, again, power control proven crucial for BSG, get the tag pro lead, shutting down the flattest grabs, and a nice easy cap for DZ.
And while such pro with a bit of a great grab there, very aggressive, full speed on the flag, and managed to squeeze out and maybe relieve a bit of pressure for his team, and maybe they could start him back. He's coming in here, he's only got 2 ahead at the moment, he's probably going to end up with 4 ahead. He's going quickly round the outside, only 1 in base, 2 in base, the boxer there, he goes for the bomb, he misses out by a pixel. Carver's got a rolling bomb. He's got a lot of work to do. He uses it to get past Sunny and Pookie with a snipe from hand. JJ Paul, does he know that rolling bomb's top? He chooses not to go for it. Pookie gets it. He goes past DZ, but DZ gets a return. Can Wild Switch Pro get the re-grab? He does. But he gets a face full of spike. And he has very much enjoyed the spikes today, Wild Switch Pro, hasn't he? Bit accident prone.
Yeah, sorry. I think a few players have been accident prone this game. Actually, Sunny spikes first a few times.
Sisu would be proud of how accident-prone they've been.
Sisu, Mr. Accident-prone this season. Compared to Mr. November, who is Flickyoli.
And Sunny gets a grab. She'll do well to get out there as JJ Paul gets a return. We've got 2 minutes 10 left. And currently, BSG are up by one cap. They're winning 4-3 at the moment. And Sheldon, you confident your team are going to hang on to this?
I hope so. Green's been playing really well. I think he got 2 solo returns for that cap there, so he's doing really well keeping it in base.
Solo returns seem to be the new hot thing in the eLTP at the moment.
Oh, fuck, I'm terrible at them. I mean, I'm pretty terrible at paired returns, never mind if solo returns become a thing. But Wild Switch Pro looking to bring it in here, there is a tag pro at the other end, he'll do well to do that. As Green gets
Carbon's
returned, Carbon
two.
Is coming in, there is a tag pro behind now, so he should probably force it. He tries to boost off the corner, trying to be fancy, and he doesn't get anywhere with it. There's a minute 30 left, can Carbon and the rest of Fred Ball Salzburg get back in this game? Wild Switch Pro is trying to do just that. He grabs and he avoids a team block from Carbon and he boosts in. But Pookie is sort of in the right place, right time. They get the return. Carbon's got the re-grab. He'll do well to get out here. There's quite a lot to do. He uses a bomb. And he tries to go past Green, but Green isn't buying any of that. But Sunny's got out at the other end and there's a minute left. A minute left in this half, or BSG are going to take the first half. Can we see something dramatic? Wild Switch Pro narrowly avoids getting sniped by DZ and he gets out of base and he takes a boost just ahead of Green. He's been very aggressive as Wild Switch Pro in this game and it's not paid off quite for his team just yet. With 44 seconds down by 1. He's going to go and pick up that juke juice. Can that keep him alive for a bit longer? JJ Poole could get the return on Sunna here. Surely he's got a juke juice. Surely they can get the return on Sunna. Sunna does great to live as Wild Switch Pro rolls over the flag spot. And they should have got the return a lot quicker there as Pookie gets out. And there's 30 seconds left. Can Carbon bring the flag home? 11 needs to get the return on Pookie. He does. But no one's on. They're not getting the reset. But Wild Switch Pro trying to get it. But DZ is going to get out. Carbon's sitting on the flag square. But no one's giving chase right now. They've still got the re-grab. And DZ goes to the top. There's 10 seconds. They leave the re-grab. They go aggressive. They get the return. 8 seconds. Can Fred Ball get the equaliser as the first game going to? Carbon's got to go for it. Pookie's in place. He goes for it. Oh! He missed it by a pixel. A game of pixels. Great play there by Fred Ball Salzburg. They gunned for it. They left the re-grab. They had 3 chases. They got the return. They got the reset. Carbon boosted it just at the right time, but missed it by a pixel. Oh, Mike, that was a great play, but just didn't come off for Fred Ball.
Oh, that's heartbreaking for Carbon. You know, he did the right thing. He was patient, waited for the opportunity, got a straight boost to the flag, and just missed it by a pixel.
Oh,
I hate to see that.
That was Sheldon, mate. I mean, that was brown trousers time, surely.
Well, yeah, you can say that again. I mean, when Wild Switch rolled over the flag toe when Sunny was at the bottom there, I don't know how she survived that either. I mean, I thought that was a sure cap.
It's a great job from Sunny to stay alive in that situation, especially with the Duke Juice chasing.
I don't know how she stayed alive. I was sure she was going to get returned. I was sure. That was a very, very good game. It was a very good game. I mean, LP, we'll come to you. I mean, they're definitely still in the game, Fred Ball. They showed there that they can match BSG.
Well, yeah, definitely. I mean, Carbon not getting that cap in the last second must be a true heartbreaker. But they still got a second game to go.
Okay, so we're just waiting for both teams. Just confirm they're ready. And it was really hard luck for Carbon. Carbon, one of the nice guys. He won the REMS Award this season as well. He put in so much work behind the scenes. And he's improved a lot in the actual Tag Pro side. And just missed it by a pixel.
Fred Ball seemed a lot better at the end with the power-ups.
Like, that's a good point.
The last half, they really upped their game on the power-ups, but a worse result in the half.
Yeah, they seem to be getting back into it near the end. And Dr. C is back, so we can launch the group. Dr. C is hopefully back.
I'm here.
Good stuff, we're just waiting for you to get back.
Bitch, be cool.
There's someone been annoying on stream, by the way, Doctor. Someone called Little Meat Sheldon.
Oh, what's he doing?
Oh, I know who that is.
Say Sheldon's got Little Meat.
I know who it is.
What's the name and shame?
That would be my NLTP offensive partner, Pappy.
Okay.
He's blocked now, don't worry.
Yeah, he's very annoying.
Yeah, he's blocked.
Do you carry him as well?
All the time.
The other way around.
He doesn't block for me.
3 tag throws, 1 in 27 chance, yes again.
Oh shit, he's live.
We are live.
Yeah, you're on a black screen.
Whoopsie, I didn't hear any sound.
2 tag throws for Fred Ball, 1 for BSG. There's a tag throw lead coming in, but again, there's a tag throw on the flag square.
I've got the picture.
There's a return for cap situation. Can I get close to 11?
Oh, Pookie's they could do it here. Pookie's no still on the flag spot. Sonny's going to protect him. No, the tag pro runs out. 11 gets returned. Now can Pookie nubstep them a little bit? No, he can't. And gets sniped by Carbon. And
he gets the snipe that time.
Making early in. Sorry for missing the start of that game. I just didn't even realise that he'd launched. Maybe give me a heads up next time, Mike.
I did start speaking, you know. Said we'd gone. Said you were here launching.
Oh, I didn't know you were launching. I'm sorry. I'm an amateur. Normally I just have to talk shit. I don't have to coordinate things. I think once I streamed like an entire like game like black screen just talking, but didn't realise the picture wasn't up. Oh, that's a great return there by DZ. Absolutely sick there. And let's see if they can capitalise. He goes for another sniper. JJ Paul manages to get out green, go for the bottom. He's going to pick up that tag pro and then kiss the other flag carrier. Pookie's got a rolling bomb juju. So all 3 power-ups going to BSG. How many times have we said that today? So he's not looking for the kiss like a true attacker. Not wanting to keep the flag for herself, that's what she wants. Pookie's going to get the re-grab. Rasic Pro is on the other side of the base, though. And he could come in
11.
Here.
Huge play.
Oh, he should have gone straight for the flag.
Yeah.
Should have gone for that.
Oh, had the angle there.
So close there. I missed that. I was looking at the wrong bit. What happened to 11?
He got a double tap return on a rolling bomb.
I'm gonna say because they had the rolling bomb. I didn't think they needed watching. I didn't think anything was gonna happen for the next 30 seconds. Pookie grabs. Carbon's in base, so Pookie going for the kiss. He's not managed to kiss yet. Green nearly knocks him into the spike, and that could have been drastic for BSG there. Carbon boosts down the right hand side. No one's really giving chase. Green coming around one side. He's not really being too aggressive with that, and actually just hits a re-grab. And Carbon just sitting there. Sonny getting out of base. There's a tag pro bottom. No one goes for it. DZ goes for it and goes to probably help lead Sonny. Are they going to be aggressive with this? They are. DZ takes out Wild Such Pro. He's going to go take out the re-grab. Only Green giving chase, though. Is Pookie going to give chase? Is Pookie going to give chase? Just Green chasing so far. It's a return for a cap. They need to double up on their chasing. There's really no point doing that, and it's not worked out for them. I mean, one person chasing on this map, Sheldon, it's quite difficult, isn't it? I mean, unless you're fat, I guess, but otherwise it can be quite difficult.
it's very difficult. There's a lot of blocks they can hide behind, and you're not really going to get around them to get a return.
I mean, Mike, if you're using that tactic, if you decide to have your tag pro lead on almost any map, is that the point where you probably, if you're gambling in that way, you should probably leave the re-grab, have 2 people get the return, and then you get the cap. I mean, it's kind of high risk, high reward, but what do you think
of
that?
Yeah, if you've got tag pro protection, you need to be screaming at the re-grab to get off it and get the return as soon as you can. The tag pro should mean you stay alive most of the time. So there's no point in the regrab there. You just need to scream.
Oh, Carbon could be ahead. Sorry to cut you off. Carbon could be ahead now. He's got three ahead, but he's got a rolling bomb. He's coming in through the back. He's surely going to be a cap here. No! No, he's not. He's knocked Pookie. He went for it. He knocked Pookie into the flag. Pookie somehow survives and gets out. Carbon still carrying the base, but Green gets a return. And they're desperately unlucky there. And Carbon just cannot buy a cap in these last 5 minutes of play. He's come so close twice now. Pixels away from it. But DZ's coming in. It could be flipped the other way around. I've lost the plot. I've had too much to drink. BSG coming into cap as DZ boosts to the top right corner to stay alive. And Sheldon, Carbon being a bit unlucky so far.
Yeah, like, as I say, like, I didn't say anything, but Wormy's very unpredictable, so he's very unfortunate not to cap there. I thought it was a guaranteed cap.
And it's one of the reasons why this map is quite good for competitive. That's why it gave us a great final. I mean, it's one of these maps that's very tight, but also gives the added bonus of a little bit of unpredictability.
Yeah, sure, yeah. It's got, yeah, definitely a very predictable element with those bombs in base. But looks like 11's coming in.
He is, but Green gets a re-grab with a rolling bomb. He lives, avoids great using jukes. The rolling bomb. Nearly, it's great shoots. He lured well such pro, and his ankles will be sore after that. Pookie gets out. Carbon boosts up to the top right to survive. And neither team able to reset. We've yet to have a cap so far in this game. 11 with 10 returns so far, leading the way. He's got 10 of his team's 20 returns so far. Sunny grabs in the top right, and her flag is back in base. They do have a reset, do BSG, and this is but JJ Paul with a nice return there. Good use of the boost and the wall. Pookie gets a re-grab. Oh, and he lures Wildtouch Pro in, but Wildtouch Pro hits back with that bomb, and 11's coming in here. He goes through the spikes. DZ follows him, and he tries to split them in Green, but isn't able to. 4 minutes 45 left on the clock, and this game is tightening up. Carbon boosts around. He goes back towards the base, but he doesn't have a flag at home. JJ Paul's going to go and get the re-grab, but DZ and Green are going to be giving close chase, and JJ Paul not able to get out, and both teams have a reset, Mike.
Yeah, frantic stuff. I mean, no team's really able to go grab an advantage this game. Carbon should have capped, a bit unlucky not to, and that's the main thing so far.
Rockets have a nice snipe there, and they get a double return there on both Sunny and Pookie. JJ Paul, while such pro, trying to get things going. JJ Paul gets a good grab there. He managed to just roll away from Green and DZ. DZ gets the return. While such pro wasn't on the regrab. He was trying to help with the blocks to help his teammate get out of base to allow the regrab opportunities to come more easy in the future. But the power-ups are spoiling. There's at least four balls battling for mid, and most of them get boosted away. And rolling bomb spawns. That gets diffused very quickly. JJ Paul's waiting for top, and he gets a tag pro. And can he use that to get Fred Ball Salzburg the cap that they desperately need? While such pro yet to grab. Green comes with they're not really utilising that tag pro the way they should. And Pookie's got away. JJ Paul's grab. 11 gets the return, which he really needed to, because they got themselves in trouble there, Fred Ball Salzburg. And suddenly nearly getting ahead of three. And Sheldon, they really should use that tag pro better.
Sheldon is muted and deafened suddenly. Well, but I'll take over. It wasn't great communication, it seemed like, from Wildtouch Pro and JJ. Seems to be kind of avoiding each other almost. Not what you want.
Wildtouch Pro's got out there, he's got ahead of two, he takes the boost. Sunny grabs, so he's ahead of three. Oh, he doesn't quite get the angle. Green's got the angle on him and manages to get the return. But Carbon knocking at the door here. Ah, Fred Ball Salzburg, the power-ups are spawning. Can JJ Paul get something exceptional from the middle? A tag pro to help out his teammate. He's battling with Sunny for it. DZ comes, it's just a rolling bomb, it's diffused. Carbon waiting for bottom, hoping for a rolling bomb or a juke juice of sorts. He takes a boost, he goes past it at the time, he thinks it's coming. But he's coming into base. They're all going for the power-ups, and that allowed Carbon to come into base. And he only had one to beat, but managed to get returned. 11 hits a bomb, not a smart bomb, and that's allowed Sunny ahead. And Wildtouch does need to stay alive. Sunny is ahead, and that's a good kiss from Wildtouch, but 11 spikes himself, and we've got a bit of a reset. And this is a tight half, Mike.
Yeah, no caps. Normally you see at least one cap, you know, one sick mistake here or there. It's just not happened yet.
And is it being poor offense or good defense?
Honestly, I'd say poor offense. The defenses have played well, but you'd expect a bit more from the attackers, maybe.
Oh, and that's a nice double return from Green there, getting the one down in the bottom left, and then boosting up to shut down the regrab. The four defenders in blue there should get the return. The power-ups are spawning again with both flags back in base. And this should be interesting because all the power-ups surely will be heavily contested. Four balls in the middle there. But Wild Switch Pro's got a grab in the meantime. There's a rolling bomb again, diffused in the middle. Wild Switch Pro heads to the bottom and his team. Oh, but he doesn't get... He loves to get a face full of spike again as Carbon gets a regrab. Carbon gets a regrab and that's good, but Sunny's got out at the other end and DZ's got a Tag Pro lead just to kind of help her out. He's not actually leading, he's getting a great bomb return instead as Sunny gets returned in the top of the map there. Great boost by Wild Switch Pro to cover most of the map and Pookie needs to live here and Pookie does live. Carbon actually team blocks his own person and JJ Paul needs to live now. They're in big trouble here at BSG. JJ Paul needs to live. Wild Switch Pro gets ahead though, the boost were there at the right time to allow Fred Ball Salzburg. That's a risky grab from Carbon, and he really needs to live, and he does. It's bold play, but that's what this game needs right now. It needs bold plays as Carbon comes into base, but no one to help him get the reset, and he has to run the map a bit. 1 minute left. Can Fred Ball Salzburg take a lead into the second half? BSG going to hold on right now. They won the first game. All they need is a draw in the second, and they will be the ELTP Miners champions of Season 4. But right now, Carbon is hanging around base. I think JJ Paul's trying to get a reset, and it nearly worked out, but Pookie manages to grab and get away. Carbon's on the flag spot. Can they get the return? But Green comes chasing for him. Oh, there were seconds in that. But Carbon could bring it in. There's two to beat. There's two blockers. He's going to force it, but Sunner comes and gets the return. 30 seconds left. Wild Switch Pro forcing it. Carbon, is he going for the He is going for the regrab. Wild Switch Pro is looking to bring it in. There's three to beat. One right behind him. He doesn't use that bomb. And the bomb ends up clearing base out a little bit. And there's 15 seconds. Carbon's going to try and force it. He takes one boost out so it can't be used against him. 10 seconds. Can Fred Ball Salzburg bring anything home? They can't. They should sut Sunner down here. And they do. And this half's finished 0-0. We're going down to one half to decide the ELTP Miners Championship, Mike. And it's going to be a tight one.
Yeah, tense half. I mean, Green and DZ did a great job on defence. 24 returns between them, 11 stand out for Fred Ball Salzburg, 19 returns for himself. And a tight half. Offence is not really doing that great a job. Carbon had some nice holes, 3 minutes 49, and on the flag square a couple of times, but just didn't line up nicely. I think Carbon deserves a couple of caps the way he's played, though.
He has played very, very well. It's been such a tight game. I can't believe 0-0. And yeah, I mean, Fred Ball Salzburg, the pressure's on them now. And LP, I mean, going into this game, where they have to win. You know, like, some teams kind of do really well with the pressure and some don't. How do you see Fred Ball doing?
Oh, Fred Ball. They need to pull together here. One quick cap, though, and it could be all the other way around with BSG needing to push.
And who will be the characters, open question to anyone, who will be the characters in the Fred Ball Salzburg channel now that will be spurring their team on to get this cap that they need?
Oh, I'd go with Carbon, to be honest.
I reckon Sam as well might be having a bit of a weird. He got the cool as a cucumber, where a very supportive player. You heard him in that channel when his team conceded the four caps in like 30 seconds. He stayed cool and calm and collected throughout that. And I reckon he'll be having a big impact. Mike, your thoughts?
Yeah, definitely. Sam's always been like a calming presence from what I've heard in games. He'll need to inspire his team, though. Obviously, Fred Ball Salzburg, led by Fred, as you could probably guess. And it'll be interesting to see what they can do to come back in this game.
And yet again, we find...
Maybe a sub.
We find Ballis Saint Germain just one half away from a title. Are they going to hold on to it, or are they going to choke, Mike?
That's a tough prediction to say. Yesterday everyone backed BSG and you saw what happened. I am going to back BSG again, though. Pookie's too experienced, DZ and Green are a great defensive pairing. Sun has played really well despite the lag. I think they'll just edge it over Fred Ball Salzburg. How about yourself? Who do you think is going to win?
I don't care.
I'm
reading the stream, making sure I've not all gone hobbits at one point because I'm a bit of a fool.
You did.
Not for that. But when I saw that, I thought I'd accidentally the whole game. I realised how can I stream like the YouTube? No, I'm not recording it. I'm not a smart.
It does look like 5v4, and Newcomb said he can ban two players of Newcomb tactics. It has to be said.
What sub does it look like is happening? Reset. I think
There is
Mr.
No
Joe Hobo's jumped into Red.
Drag him out.
Pardon?
Sam said to drag him out.
Mr. Joe Hobo has been.
Someone's bullying me on the street.
Salzburg needs to sit to overtime.
Who's Lewis?
Bull.
Son has. I think the internet's died.
Not the router.
Oh. That does make sense. Is Lewis McLennan Dr. Toby?
Yeah.
Is that his last name?
Yeah.
Okay.
No.
So just wait. Possibly come. And Voodoo's jumped out. Voodoo is doing the hokey cokey.
Can Voodoo play?
Yes.
What are the rules?
Again, I'll delegate to LP, my mind's committed.
I still need to look at the stats for that.
Is Lewis McLennan definitely...
Yeah.
Because Big is asking who he is.
Perfect.
Oh. Yeah, sorry. Hashtag that's a joke. Damn it.
He must be happy with Aston Villa's performance yesterday. Making it to the FA Cup final.
Not as
prestigious as this final, though.
Actually, I could. It's not that surprising.
I think 90,000 Wembley viewers. 90,000 Wembley viewers has got nothing. Eight people viewer. eLTP fine.
Mediocre meat shell to say Dr. McSvort equals chickens scratching hamsters' backs while they sing a gentle song.
I think that's a compliment.
I really is up if anything.
Fine.
Oh, and Toby was actually in the game where Aston Liverpool.
He did send the day. Are you happy?
I would be as well, bloody ass. For crying out. Yeah, I know.
I'm sorry to hear that, man.
Definitely getting relegated.
It's like Sun is back in.
Camphor's in. Dramatic
oh, Camphor's
stuff.
Back in. Camphor the pal.
How much is Camphor?
Glad you asked me that. Oh shit, I've lost the page. I'm not glad you've asked me that. 180 minute. From what? 4 point. So not amazing standard. Camphor the Panther. Joined through the season. Under Shell. Has grown into a solid offensive player.
Solid, I like
that. About Sam.
It does look like he is staying.
4.12 offensive gas for Camphor. 33 plus minus though. They do seem to win a lot when he's on the team.
I never know what that is. What is it?
Difference when you're playing. It shows that Camphor, you know, maybe not, but BHD win when he's on the pitch.
Interesting stuff. Are these teams ready?
But that's actually one of the league.
Goes to overtime.
No, it's not.
I'm not streaming it.
Plus minus for BSG. Statistical move here. Oh, the I'm launching.
Ah!
Right. We have launched.
I'm with you this time. I'm a professional streamer. I take the Tag Pro very seriously. I actually the work and nearly missed this game.
First. Welcome back, Sheldon.
Yep.
What can you say going in?
Well, my mind is that I don't like seeing it. It's, I feel like everyone should have a chance. Should go in. He's very talented, but
I like that.
That's a bit of a...
Michael, oh, JJ Paul's coming in! It was so close, then. And whilst it's probably equalising Cap early on, realised. Oh my god.
More there.
Camphor
didn't close down the angle, maybe, you know, a bit rusty.
Sure.
Yeah?
Oh, sorry. I just said, don't think it's going to be good for the stream. And 50.
Is it visible?
It does.
Oh no, I don't know why this has happened. The game
just went through. Boost off.
The stream is pretty low.
As a V kind of backdoor, boosted on top wall. Pass cameras
now.
We've got double attack, bro. JJ Paul's coming in the middle, so I doubt BSG are going to manage to get out. I'm that's having like visual problems with the stream. My started not working, which never happens.
Oh,
it would have taken the lead and shoot caps up. The substitution has not worked out. G, they are losing in a final, and all I could do is the fact that Mike, what do I do?
I'm not. Camphor coming in top. He's got the boost.
He boosts down.
I'm not brilliant.
Team as Camphor comes down the right hand side, but the boost wasn't too good. A well grab, and he's come up. He's sitting at the bottom of the map, and he's going to go. He is going to chase the Blues. Remember, BSG only down by 2-5. Ooh, it nearly worked out there. But JJ, he gets sniped by Green. They've got a tag pro. I don't know if they can get and get the top as Pookie is hanging around the similar. Narrowly avoids the return. Green gets it, and Pookie's going to come and sit square. Green grab. He and they've got a bit of a reset here.
Ooh. Could have been ahead. Nervous play. I'll take over. Probably nervous. Oh, great. You know, just splits JJ in 11. And again, Camphor's snuck in.
So dirty gap. What? Nice. That one there. I can't believe that cap and Pookie is it, but he's not absolutely sick cap there. Showing my cap there to get his team back. A very, very tight game. And what a time for the Ping 900. Still carrying beautifully here. Get his BSG down 30 left in the ELTP minus final. Hi, Mike, I'm going to just double check my internet. Keep it going.
I can for though. I mean, he did the split on, and someone, I think it was JJ Paul, maybe. Great split, snuck in the left hand side, and some great Fred Ball defense, sorry. I think it was Green with the blocks, and Camphor. And I was just slagging them off, that'll boost his confidence.
Cap of the game.
It was cap. Same as the Sheldon's. Sneaking in, great Jukes.
This might be a cap.
Welsh's first coming in, he's got one there.
Let him cap.
And it's 3-1 to Fred Ball Salzburg. I'm just game going to overtime. After nil, if it's stepped up in this half. Both teams going for it. Return by Green. Fantastic. Green stood out for me on defense this game.
He is. It does look to be working regardless.
That was fantastic. You meant it. Green with another solo return. Pookie. Green's got 10 returns already. Fantastic performance all night from him. I think he's been my MVP on defense.
The MVP of the whole game.
Could boost in here. He's not quite got an angle. He's waiting to get ahead.
Maybe they should have used
the bomb is there. Oh, Jay's got a tag throw. If he clicks by Green, I think Green fat. Bag. We could.
Oh, Pookie. Nice.
Pookie's staying alive.
That was nice. I can only apologise to everyone for the stream. We'll be able to upload a video of a best. And if you'll stay with us, as you can see, corner of Mike. But right now, we have a great game with 4 minutes. With final BSG down by one cap to lucky carrying through the minute and he kisses
easy
to get out.
Three.
If they get this return, they show he's not can't see that they were ahead of four and it's an equalized carbon with the one boost available. And BSG 3 minutes 40 left as Camphor a tag pro important, but JJ Paul's also got a tag pro carbon to escape, but he boosts straight into Green. Camphor's a minute being given chase by Carbon 11 and JJ Paul, which is boosting around base. And all they've got to do for a ball falls onto the flat. What a
not
close.
An easy thing.
We're getting a nice final yet again. Throw's going to cap, and he has capped. Came at the wrong with 3 minutes left. And,
it's far
from. See again?
No.
Oh, Carbon's led him. Carbon snapped a couple of ankles. Coming in, he's passed on the outside. But all of them have got ahead. A loop by him. He's coming in. He's not.
Bomb re-grab. Well, such players got the rolling bomb.
Re-grab. Pookie just ran.
Two tackle leads. Boost. Well, such players need to be careful now as well. Both.
Easy.
Nearly. Green's going, trying to go aggressive.
Is he winning a return? They need the solo return. Go, Green! Oh! Hits himself. 2 minutes left.
Nearly a great. There's 2 minutes left. BSG need two. Otherwise, it's BSG.
Grab there by Pookie.
Camphor with a great boost from Green. Green could be doing a fat. Deezy's not.
Cup, he needs his cup. One more cup to get, and Camphor's looking to. Now, one. If they get a cup, we are going to over. Is that right, Mike?
Yes. If there's one more cup, BSG will win.
No. Sorry, I'm talking rubbish. I've lost track of what's going on. BSG or Salzburg are going to enforce this game. Time. Pooh narrowly avoids getting sniped.
Great,
by
Jason
11.
JJ.
Doing brilliantly. Deezy gets returned to the end. While such pro, though, he needs to live. He should have looked for that kiss. You're right there, Sheldon. As Pooh gets towards Dukas, Carbon grabs. 1 minute left on the clock. Fred Ball Salzburg clinging onto their hopes of taking the game to JJ Poole. Oh, Poole is hanging to return to come in. While such pro. Sheldon forced to grab.
That was incredible play. I mean, but 11 managed to sneak out a great boost on Well Such Pro. 30 seconds.
Pookie was a great jump. They have to go this.
Not a great.
Oh, JJ. Oh, and Well Such Pro really needs. Still got that. Well Such Pro managed to.
30 seconds. BSG need a cap to make
game.
It. Not like it's going to happen. Fred Ball looked like okay. Pookie can stay alive. And this. Overtime. Wow, so amazing performance. He's pulling a fat here. 18 returns. Wow, such progress. And as I said, it's going to overtime. Reminder of the overtime rules.
We stream.
Okay, there will be a short break as well. Was said five chatter. So as a reminder of the overtime rules, if we just look at the rules quickly. A 10-minute game is played, and the winner is the team with the highest end of the 10 minutes. It looks like it will be on the same teams wanted. If they're tied after the first, another overtime is played, and two overtimes, the teams are still tied on death. But wow, I'm capping it each time. Game, who's here to talk? Heisenberg.
Yeah.
What do you think about that game?
That was much more open. I think Camphor might have up the sort of duking than Sunny, but Sunny made better decisions and as many flaccids. To more caps.
Did Mike start the game? I think so.
Pardon?
I mean, Wales was progress leaving 5 minutes and. Waiting for BSG to call it, and then we should start the game.
If BSG are ready, we're trying our best for the stream and the game. I don't even know if I'm just waiting.
Well, I don't know if they can hear.
Just waiting to see if BSG is back. I assume Doc is sorting out the issues. And Fred Ball Salzburg want to start this. Such a key player for them. He got 4 caps in that last game. All their caps. And it was pro can play. Carbon doing a countdown. Unlike Carbon. Perhaps the pressure getting to him. DC says it's the final count. Carbon's counting skills. Not great.
Pandana's cool. 5 minutes.
Game has been going on a long time.
What does that mean? It has to start by.
Oh, to back up stream. It is not ideal. Hopefully, Jeff can do a backup stream. I'm gonna. I need to track someone out. Friday, I'm sorry. After has been tagged in. Just wait for SG, you're ready. SG, ready? You need to drag, find Jofter and drag him up here. We're just for BG to take the ready carbon.
He's in Intercourse Island. Drag him in.
Stream might be swapping over to Jofter's stream. Hitbox.tv/. As a reminder, hitbox.tv/Jofter. Where the stream will hopefully. Still waiting just as we are ready. It would help if I unmute. Oh, it seems like they've lost well such pro. That is controversial. Is not. Well, such pro has had to leave. That is, you know, it's a problem sometimes, you know, different time zones. Well, such pro is disconnected, that's going to affect a lot.
And BSG have got Sana back.
BSG have got Sana back. Reminder on hitbox.tv/Jofter. And we're just. Pandana doing the 2-minute countdown. Apparently Icy Pickle, who was left in the jar too long. thank you for that. I don't think I can link it in the chat allows it.
Who said that?
Meet Sheldon. The chat does not allow links, hence I'm hitbox.tv. Okay, the teams are ready. Don't know about the stream situation. Jofter hasn't launched Mumble.
Go.
I'm launching.
Jofter needs to we'll get.
I don't know. Watch you as soon.
I hope that it'll, like.
Find Jofter. Drag him back in.
Sorry, Mike.
He's in straight, you got him.
I kept on missing him. There is a Duke and bottom. A hit TV/Jofter. Live there with Jofter's fancy texture pack. A nice clear stream, hopefully.
So is it the basically the
score?
Yep.
So and Sonnet is away here.
Here is. Oh no, she gets bombed into some spikes and more or less. DZ is the Juke Juice, and so live after that delay, and such pro had to leave and comes in for.
Yeah. Well, such pro. Had to leave. Drake closing the door by Pandani. Game.
Oh, him. Sack him.
I hear your fantastic rules, so we remind the players in the game.
Come in. So I'm very sorry about all that. It's thrown me off. People can see what's going on. Let's. The last night. Carter gets returned. Coming in though. She's got a. She's got three ahead of her though. Let's the bomb tries to create through the right hand side, and there's a flag for a slot. He's spawned on that bomb, which puts them to get the return. A close air shot.
Graham prepped our attack.
I'm gonna stop my stream and unwatch.
More pups again. Two rolling